What's in a name? What's in a name? Did you know that Huso Huso, Panthera uncia, and Aquila nipponensis are all species native to Kazakhstan? Perhaps you know these animals better by their common names, the beluga sturgeon, the snow leopard, and the steppe eagle. Have you ever wondered about the origin of these scientific names? It dates all the way back to Aristotle in ancient Greece. Aristotle created the field of taxonomy to describe and organize life forms. The word comes from the ancient Greek words taxis, meaning arrangement, and nomia, meaning method. Early taxonomy was based on the type of organism, a plant, an animal, a bird, or a fish, and the description of its characteristics. Aristotle began to classify living organisms based on their attributes, such as giving birth to live young, laying eggs, and having blood or not having blood. These attributes roughly equate to the categories mammals, non-mammals, vertebrates, and invertebrates that we use today. Theophrastus, a student of Aristotle's, went on to name around 500 plants and their uses in Historia Plantarum, and as a result, came to be known as the father of botany. In the 18th century, Carl Linnaeus, a Swedish botanist, became the father of modern taxonomy. He changed the way organisms were classified using their class, order, genus, and species, which came to be known as the Linnaean system. He also introduced a standardized binomial naming system in the 18th century, using a two-part scientific name made up of the genus and a name for that particular species. Today, almost every organism on our planet has a scientific name. However, there are still some places that harbor unknown species, such as the depths of our oceans and our unexplored forests and jungles.